are. I'm going to plug back in because I just unplugged. John and I are on a little mini vacation. We are up here in steamboats getting ready to go skiing. See how pretty it is out there? Any skiers online? Go ahead and why don't you text about 5 people and say, let's do Bible study together. I have a word in my spirit for you. We're getting ready. We like to ski around 10:30 or so when it gets nicer out. So I was studying the word this morning, doing all my work, getting everything done, going to eat a little breakfast and head on out on the slopes and have a good time. But if you've got your Bible, go with me to Joshua. And let's look at Joshua chapter, Joshua chapter 6. And I really feel that this is a word for someone who's saying, man, God has given me a promise. He said, take possession, but it seems like it's impossible. There's absolutely no way through. How am I ever going to get there? Well, this is what the word of the Lord says in Joshua chapter 6, and we'll look right here. And I'm going to talk to you about how God is getting ready to open up a door supernaturally, and no man is going to be able to shut it. The Bible says, now Jericho was straitly shut up because of the children of Israel. I could stop right there. Jericho was straitly shut up. Jericho was a strategic city because God had already said, go take possession. Take possession of the land that I have given you. There are promises that God has given you. There are things that God says, it's yours. You'll have that business. You'll have that family. You'll see restoration. You'll see the goodness of God. You'll have that ministry. And yet Jericho was straitly shut up. It means it was impenetrable. Nothing was coming in. Nothing was going out. No ingress, no egress. It was absolutely shut up. And it says that Jericho was straitly shut up because of the children of Israel. Now that's interesting because God had so much made the reputation of the children of Israel that he was with them, that Jericho and all the other cities literally feared them because of God. You see, God is going to cause people to bless you that don't even like you. God is going to cause people to open up doors of favor. They're kind of like, I'm not so sure about them. But you see, the Lord will give you a great reputation for his name's sake. The Lord will give you a favor for his name's sake. So they were afraid of letting the children of Israel in because they were like, man, do you know the God that they serve? And that's the testimony that God will give you. And so it says, and the Lord said unto Joshua, I've given you the land of Israel. This is what it actually says. It says, and the Lord said unto Joshua, see, I've given into thine hand Jericho. Interesting, because hand always means power. And he says, I've given into your power, into your hand, Jericho, and the king thereof, and the mighty men of valor. In other words, the thing that controls Jericho, the king, the armies, the things that are not letting you get in, I've given it into your hand. Joshua, it seems impossible, but I'm going to give you favor. I'm going to give to you the king, the armies, everything that pertains to you taking possession, because if you don't get through Jericho, you're not going to be able to possess the land. And so he goes on, and you shall compass the city. Now, this is where it gets wild. It's great. God's giving you the hand of the king of Jericho and the mighty men of valor. And he says, but you're going to compass the city, all the men of war, and go around about it once. And then do it 6 days, and 7 priests will bear the ark of 7 trumpets of ram's horns, and on the 7th day, you'll compass the city 7 times. God is into details. And 7 times, and the priests shall blow with the trumpets, and it will come to pass that when they make a long blast with the ram's horn, and when you hear the sound of the trumpet, all the people will shout with a great shout, and the wall of the city shall fall down flat. And the people will ascend up every man straight before him. Now let's stop right there because God says, all right, I've given you the city. You need this to possess the promise. And I've given you the king and I've given you the army. But this is what I want you to do. I want you to march around the city 6 times. And on the 7th day, I want you to march around 6 times in silence. On the 7th day, march around, blow the sound of the shofar is what it is, the long ram's horn. And the wall, the thing that is a barrier, is going to fall down flat and going to become a bridge for you. So whatever is standing in your way, whatever restriction, whatever barrier, God says, as you praise me, as you follow my instruction, as you're obedient to any illogical instruction, that thing which is a barrier is about to become a bridge. And I'm going to cause you to go into the enemy's territory. I'm going to cause you to go into places that your resume, your network, your net worth cannot take you. And I'm going to cause you to have favor. Now, this is the difficult part, because I love it. We all do when God says, I've given it to you. But then he says, oh, by the way, in order to possess it, you've got to follow a really crazy instruction. Like, Paula, leave Tampa and go to Apopka, Florida. Apopka? How do you even say that? Apopka? Apopka? Go do what I tell you to do. See, the Lord will tell you, amen, Carice. So great to see you all on here. God will give you an instruction that is illogical, that doesn't make sense to your natural mind. But when you obey it, when you know God says, do it, give me a praise, do something that is just totally crazy to the natural mind. If your mind can comprehend it and it makes sense, it's usually not God. It's when it's, all right, this is a step of faith. And Lord, when you say to do it, I'm going for it. Because that's what happened. Verse 6. And Joshua the son of Nun called the priests, said to them, take up the ark of the covenant and let the seven priests bear the seven trumpets of the ram's horns before the ark of the Lord. And he said to the people, pass, compass the city, and let him sound the alarm, pass the ark. And it came to pass. That's always when it's good. It came to pass. All right, when Joshua had spoken unto the people, the seven priests bearing the seven trumpets of the ram horns passed before the Lord. They blew the trumpets. The ark of the covenant of the Lord followed them. The armed men went before them. So the ark compassed the city. And you know the story. And what happened is the wall fell down. And it became, that barrier became their bridge, and they crossed over and took possession of Jericho. Man, I'm telling you, some of you, sometimes it's so difficult. God gave me an instruction recently. He said, Paula, build the studio. He said, go back on television and just go on everything you can airtime. I want you to go on. I'm like, okay, Lord. So naturally you'd think, well, there's millions of dollars in the bank and there's everything you have need of. There's nothing I have. I mean, there was a day that there was a multi-million dollar studio and, you know, all your HD cameras and your everything you needed. And God said, do it. So I signed the contract. I'm excited because the studio is in production. I'm doing it. And God is faithful. He's bringing in the finances. And I'm signing the contracts for airtime. And you say, well, don't you have everything? Do you have it? No, God said that he's going to use, it was a divine instruction. He said, now's the time, do it quickly. And as you do it quickly, I will favor you. And I'll cause your voice to go around the world. I know that our God is a faithful God. And whatever it is that the Lord's told you, sometimes you have to just take that step of faith. And it seems so crazy because you're waiting to go, well, do I have this? Do I have that? Is this in place? And God says, no, I want you to, whether it's march around the city 6 times in silence and then blow the ram's horn, the shofar, and praise me. And I'm going to cause that which is a barrier to become your bridge. That's the word the Lord gave me. The barriers in your life are going to become a bridge when you obey the divine instruction of the Lord. And that instruction might be, I don't know, go bless someone. Go praise me. Go on a 21-day fast. That instruction might be, pray for this person for 10 days or give to this person. Whatever the divine instruction is, the thing that is the barrier is going to become your bridge. Let's pray together. And then I'm getting ready to go skiing. There's the gondola. So time to go. Let's pray. Remember to keep each other in prayer. Let's see, Renee, what if you're not sure what he's telling you? Well, that's a great question, because, you know, you have to shut out every other voice. I would pray. I would fast. There's 8 different ways God speaks. I would submit myself to spiritual authority and accountability, make sure it's in alignment with the will of God, the word of God. You know, it never makes sense to your natural mind, but you'll have the peace of God. A peace is given by the Holy Spirit. Really seek the Lord, because that's sometimes the most difficult thing is, how do I know this is God? But they're very, maybe I'll come on and do a teaching. There's 8 different ways that God speaks, and how you follow and know the will of God. All right, let's see. Linda, praying for divine favor over your life. I come in agreement in the name of Jesus. Favor for you. Lamila, receive the word. Amen. Judy, confirmation in the battle. We'll just pray God gives you a supernatural victory. John, greater is he that's in, than he that's in the world. Amen. The same spirit that raised Christ from the dead now dwells on the inside of us. You have to be still in Jesus' name. True. Be still and know that God is Lord. I'd like to teach on that too, because a lot of people don't know what be still means. Relax, Pastor, and enjoy my time. Chris, I'm trying to. We are. John's making breakfast right now. We're getting ready to go on the slopes. This is relaxing to fulfill the purpose of God. Walls of fear and anxiety coming down. Tanya, I come in agreement. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, let everything that is a barrier, let everything that is a wall, let every restriction be overturned by the hand of God. Let the superior blood of Jesus overturn every demonic obstruction that is standing between your people and their purpose in the name of Jesus. Open our ears that we may hear what thus saith the Lord. Let us have ears to hear and eyes to see that we may receive. If there's anything in our heart, for the word says that God is love, anything that is not of love, let it be uprooted right now. Any obstruction that would hinder us from hearing your voice clearly and concisely. So let any bitterness, unforgiveness, hurt, anger, anything, any addiction, any bondage, any captivity, anything that would cause us any weariness, any brokenness that would cause us any hurt, offense, woundedness that would cause us to be separated anyway, any sin, let it be uprooted right now. We repent of our wicked ways, God. We turn to you, knowing that when we pray, you will hear us and heal our land. We lift up every single person on here, Father. We lift up their family, their finances, their calling, their purpose to you. And I decree and declare, according to Job 22, verse 28, that it will be established, that 1,000 will fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come nigh thee. We deploy the angels of the Lord to work on behalf of you, to bring you messages, to war for you, to minister to you. We just thank you, God, for victory. We thank you that according to 1 Corinthians 15:57, thanks be unto God who hath already given us victory through Christ Jesus. You have made us more than a conqueror. We are already victorious. So walk in your victory, obey your divine instruction, and watch that which has been a barrier become a bridge.